Okay, what's really important about a rope is not to use it like this where you have it coiled. If you're going to have it connected to anything that's possibly going to pull. The only time that I coil it like this is if I'm going to throw it. And that's the only time that I coil it like this. The way that you want to carry a rope for safety is like this, where you have it going back and forth, looped like that. And so that if it gets pulled, it just gets pulled like that, and there's nothing to catch your hand in. When I see people with it like this, this is a problem, because it's going to really hurt you. The majority of the injuries that we have here are rope burns, and I think of the two interns that are here right now, we have interns that have experienced multiple rope burns. So they happen. The best thing to do to avoid them is to let go of the rope. But you can't always do that, and sometimes, especially with the non-cotton ropes, they will burn your hand faster. Okay, the best way to tie up a Mustang, and the way that we use to begin with, is we simply take the rope around at least four times. At four times, the Mustang can pull it and fight it, but it can't do it automatically. Okay, so that's the very best way to keep him from getting scared. The second way, if you're going to tie him up, longer period of time, then what you want to do is that, so that you can just pull it and have it get loose. And I'm going to show that again, and then we'll probably
let me get it close up.
Okay, so what you want to do is just make a loop and put it through the loop and pull it. And that's enough right there. The horse can't get loose. But you can just pull it to get it loose.
Okay.
When you tie up a horse, you want the lead to be no longer than the bottom of their chest, because they might start pawing it and get their paws over it and get tangled up, and then they'll get really scared. So you don't really want to do that. You can just kind of figure out that's probably about the right length. If you just want to tie it in advance and then come and clip your horse to it, you can do that, but you've got to know just about there. When you're tying him up on the high line, you'll want the rope to where it just barely touches the ground, if this was the ground. And if you're tying him up so that their head's up, you want it so that it's just above the point, or just below the point of the bottom of their halter where they would stand naturally. So there's different places to tie your horse up, but you've always got to think about what's safe. Do not have a horse tied up and go under the rope. Do not do that. Do not let me catch you doing that, because I'm going to yell at you for doing that. That's really super dangerous. The safe way to get around a horse is to walk around it, okay? If you're just dealing with a domestic animal, then you can kind of think about whether or not that's safe. But with a Mustang, you can't ever think that that's safe, okay?
got the hair out of your eyes. You could actually see better. Wait! That wasn't nice. Get back. Back up. Back up. Back up. Oh, I'm not providing you with enough reinforcement to back up. Okay, back up. Back up. Back up. Oh, you're mad. I know. Back. Very good. Pretty good.